Blue Dream tells the story of Ryan Luttrell, who went from being a fan to playing pickup basketball with the Tigers coaching staff to being investigated by the NCAA for recruiting violations. He now owns his own company in California, and you've written your book, Blue Dream, about this really crazy period that just started with you being a student who was a sincere fan of the Tigers, right?
Absolutely. I apologize for my voice. This is not my normal voice.
Hey, it's sinus season in the Mid-South.
Just a fan of the program. My son was about 7 years old at the time.
Yeah.
And it was during that 2007-2008 season.
The Calipari years.
Calipari, Derrick Rose.
Yeah.
We went to the championship.
And yeah.
We were just immersed in the basketball program, you know. I mean, we wanted to just be around it constantly.
And they kind of adopted you.
Yeah, the doors, Ryan, seemed to open for you, which is kind of unheard of, was it not? I mean, they welcomed you in.
I think so. And I had some friendships with a couple of the managers there, and that sort of helped, you know, give me a little bit of legitimacy to come in.
Yeah, your son would play one-on-one with Derrick Rose, mm-hmm. of all things, mm-hmm. of course, NBA player now. Mm-hmm. You would play pickup with the coach's staff, and they started asking your advice, actually. I mean, mm-hmm. you were sort of, what would you have called yourself, an unofficial advisor?
I assume so. I was just sort of a friend, I felt like.
You know, what did you think about Calipari?
Oh, Calipari's just, he was great. You know, he was the greatest thing that had happened to Memphis at the time.
But what's also interesting is, Ryan, you seem to have been privy to a lot of intimate things going on involving the Tigers, involving some secrets, so to speak. What were you privy to?
I have this background in culinary, and that really got me into event management, and mm-hmm. I ended up going to Super Bowls and planning events. And so that sort of led into me planning AAU tournaments and events for basketball during the summer.
Right.
And I don't know, that really got me in with a lot of recruits that then gave me sort of just a dialect with the coaching staff, figuring out who they wanted, who they needed, had media coming in from that standpoint. So it was sort of that angle.
But what were you seeing there?
What was I seeing?
Yeah.
I was seeing a world of college basketball. I was seeing businesses involved. I was seeing recruits come in and out.
Yeah.
I was seeing everything.
So we all remember that day when it was announced that John Calipari was going to Kentucky, and the city really felt betrayed, largely because he took some very good players with him, some recruits. How were you surprised, and what was your reaction?
I really wasn't surprised at the time, because just working with sort of the media people that I had been working with, we had seen the build-up to this for a while, about 6 weeks.
Yeah.
And I had a couple of friends telling me, like, he's gone, he's gone. And I was like, no way. But I was shocked initially, you know. I was like, why would he leave us? Like, we're right there. You know, we had it with 2 minutes to go. We get these guys in, we've got it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And
it was a dream season.
What were your conversations like at that moment, during that time, when it was announced he was about to leave?
I mean, they were very delicate conversations. Like, I feel like it was a sort of a period where you didn't know who you could trust, whether it be a booster, a player, a manager, because we see in the end, he effectively took everybody with him from, you know, the administrative staff and the managers to everybody. So
still a fair number of Memphians who still haven't forgiven him, right?
Absolutely.
And then you were also kind of called in to help rebuild the team. Mm-hmm. I mean, with Josh Pastner, did you have a voice in the decision to bring him to
I did somewhat. I don't want to
That's
take
so
any
bizarre.
Sort of credit for
that,
it. But
does that seem bizarre to you? Because you were not paid.
Not
you
at all.
On staff.
And it was this weird situation where Josh actually reached out to a friend of mine, but then they had this sort of conflict where he couldn't say anything.
Yeah.
And so then I needed to reach out to a big booster who then made the call to Josh.
One last thing, very quickly here. What do you want the takeaway to be from those who read your book?
I want them just to see the real side of college sports. I mean, I talk about a lot of revealing things from the NCAA, recruiting, and how businesses are involved. But I also want them to just remember what a great time that was for Tigers. I mean, that was just a really magical time for me. And that's why I called it Blue Dream. I mean, it's like that dream that we just had, and all of a sudden it was over. And then now we're going to get to have it again with Penny.
Yes, we are.
By all means.
That's book two.